हेलो एवरीवन, सो दिस इज फिफ्थ वीडियो ऑन ऑर्डिनरी डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द डिफरेंशियल फार्मूलाज, लीनियर इक्वेशन एंड बर्नौलीज इक्वेशन. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद डिफरेंशियल फार्मूलाज. व्हाट इज द डेरिवेटिव ऑफ एक्स अपॉन वाई? इट विल बी एक्स एज इट इज इंटू द डेरिवेटिव ऑफ वन ओवर वाई, विच इज माइनस वन अपॉन वाई स्क्वेयर इंटू डी वाई, plus 1 over y as it is into the derivative of x. So when you take LCM and simplify this, we will have y dx minus x dy upon y square. It's a complete differential of x upon y. So in the differential equation, we can substitute this function as the derivative of x upon y. Similarly, if we have x dy plus y dx, it's a complete differential of x into y. What is the derivative of x into y? X as it is into the derivative of y plus y as it is into the derivative of x. Similarly, the derivative of x square plus y square is what? It is 2x into dx plus 2y into dy. So whenever you have such type of form in the differential equation, you can substitute it as the complete differential of x square plus y square. Now the next is derivative of tan inverse x upon y. Since we know that the derivative of tan inverse theta is 1 over 1 plus theta square, right? So what will be the derivative of tan inverse x upon y? It is 1 over 1 plus x square upon y square into the derivative of x upon y. And what is the derivative of x upon y? This is y dx minus x dy upon y square. So after simplifying this, we have y dx minus x dy upon x square plus y square is nothing but the complete differential of tan inverse x upon y. Similarly, y dx minus x dy upon xy, it's a complete differential of log of x upon y. Right? What is the derivative of log theta? It will be 1 over theta. So it will be 1 over x upon y into the derivative of x upon y. So when you substitute this over here and simplify this, we will have this is y dx minus x dy upon xy. So whenever you have such type of form in the differential equation, you can substitute it as a complete differential of log of x upon y, and you can solve the differential equation. Now just see some examples. So we are given y dx minus x dy is equal to xy cube dy. We have to solve this differential equation. Okay, so here we have the form y dx minus x dy. Now we have to see whether we divide it by x into y, y square, x, whatever. We need to find out that what will be the integrating factor of this equation so that it will become the complete differential. Now just see in the right hand side, you have to integrate with respect to y only. So there should be a function of y alone. So x should be removed from here. So we can take x to be this side, right? But we have to take y also, only then it will become the complete differential of log of x upon y. So we take x, y from here and divide over this side. So therefore integrating factor will be 1 over x into y. So we multiply this whole equation with 1 over x into y. Here x into y will be cancelled out and you left with y square into dy. Right? So now you just integrate both sides. This is a complete differential of log upon xy. Its integration is y cube by 3 plus c. So this is the solution of this differential equation using the differential formula. One more example. Now just see, you have to solve x dy is equal to x to the power 5 plus x cube plus y square plus y dx. Again, we can take this term to this side, so it will become x dy minus y dx, and we left with this 2, and we can take x cube to be common from here, and we get this is x cube x square plus y square dx. Now if we divide x by x square plus y square, we know that this is a complete differential of tan inverse x upon y. right? Here it is a function of x alone, so we can easily integrate both sides and we get the solution. So the solution will be this one. So in this way we can use the differential formulas to solve the differential equations. Next is the linear equation. A first order linear equation is given by this. So it is of the form dy by dx plus some function of x into y is equal to some function of x. So first of all we will find out the integrating factor. Integrating factor will be whatever the function over here of x, we have to integrate that function, and then e to the power that function will become the integrating factor in such case, and the solution is y into integrating factor is equal to the integral of q, which is right hand side coefficient, into integrating factor plus c. So this is the solution, right? Now for example, solve this differential equation dy by dx plus 1 over x into y is equal to 3x. Here your px is 1 over x, qx is 3x. So integrating factor will be e to the power integral of p with respect to x. So integral of p is 1 over x into dx is log x. E to the power this thing will become x. So this is the integrating factor. And the solution will be y into integrating factor. So y into x is equal to the integral of q, which is 3x into x, 3x square dx plus c. So what is the solution? X into y is equal to x cube plus c. So after integrating this factor, we will have a solution. The next is the Bernoulli's differential equation. A differential equation of the form dy by dx plus px into y is equal to qx into some factor of y. So we are having y to the power n. So whenever your n is not equal to 1, this is non-linear Bernoulli's differential equation, right? When your n is 1, this is linear form, okay? So we are having p of dy by dx plus pxy is equal to q of x into y to the power n, and we have to solve this differential equation. In this case, we first divide by y to the power n, means we take this y to the power to the left hand side, so we will have y to the power minus n over here, then px into y to the power 1 minus n is equal to qx. So now we substitute z to be y to the power 1 minus n and transform this whole equation in the terms of z and x. Okay, so we substitute this to be this. So dz by dx is what? It will be 1 minus n into y to the power minus n into dy by dx. Right? And the equation is this one, where p1x is this and q1x is this. So when you compare with linear differential equation, right, this is in the form of linear in z. Now you can solve it by finding the integrating factor, that is in the terms of z, and at last you substitute the value of z in the terms of y, you will get the solution of this differential equation. For example, let's suppose you are given the equation xy dash plus y is equal to x to the power 4 into y cube. So here it is Bernoulli's differential equation. We can divide by y cube to both sides. So we will have this is y to the power minus 3 into y dash plus y to the power minus 2 divide by x. We also divide with by x. So is equal to x cube. So we have this form, right? Now we substitute y to the power minus 2 to z. And after differentiating, we will get the value of y dash in the terms of z. Now you substitute over here. and the equation reduces to linear differential equation. Okay, so after simplifying, whatever the factor with z is your px, this is your qx, right? So your integrating factor will be what? E to the power integral of px in dx. So here px is minus 2x, so integrating factor will be 1 over x square, and the solution is z into integrating factor is equal to qx into integrating factor dx plus c. So after simplifying, this is your solution. Now you substitute the value of z in the terms of y. So it will be 1 over xy whole square equal to minus x square plus c. So this is the solution of this Bernoulli's equation. So in case of Bernoulli equation, after substituting y to the power some n, we reduce the differential equation into linear differential equation and then we can solve it, right? But in that case, we will have a solution in the form of new variable, and at last we have to substitute that value, right? So with this, your first order differential equation is completed. Thanks.